You almost had it.
Stay awake. You will play your part. You will. Stay awake. Sleep is a poor excuse. And so are you. All preparations have been made. Your little toys await you upstairs. Time waits for no one.
Testing. One, two, three.
Hunter, do not
testing,
waste
one, two, three.
Hours.
Testing. One, two, three. Testing. One, two, three. Testing. One, two, three. Testing.
One, two, three.
Testing. One, two, three.
Time plays the parts of many men. He observes the others, while the others watch him. He's expected to behave properly, wandering through worlds that aren't really there. He puts on masks and adjusts accordingly. Each mask is a character. Each character a layer. Layers upon layers, calling out to him. He must build the character he was meant to portray, or lose himself completely. Submerged, tightly surrounded by lives he's never lived. And yet, he stands on a stage where every man must play a part. And his is a sad one.
Listen, once you get there, just do what you have to do. Get to the set and build this character for him. That's all that matters. Yeah, yeah, I know you've told me a million times how much you hate the seat. And I'm telling you, this gig is just too good to pass up.
All third-class passengers this way, please. Did you check the lower decks this time? I swear to God, if we find any stowaways again, you'll never set foot on a ship again.
Never met the guy in person, but few people have. That's why you hear all these rumors about him being broken or disfigured. All that nonsense. guy's got a reputation. Makes his actors jump through hoops before he even lets him on the set. Supposed to be some new method of building the character. Bunch of artsy-fartsy bullshit, if you ask me. Just go with it. Guy doesn't take no for an answer. So what if the guy's a little nuts? He's a director. He comes with a job. I mean, what's he gonna do? Kill ya? I think it's all an act.
Before the world told you who you should be, do you remember who you were? Come. I will make you remember.
I believe in you. Wake up, Mr. Hardy. We've got to get out of this godforsaken prison before we rot.
Are we really going? Lily, I'm...
That's Captain Baines to you, Mr. Hardy. Remember the name, Quartermaster, or I'll have you walk the plank.
These images, memories of you, they've been haunting me.
And yet you cling to them, because without me, you have nothing.
I'm back, Mahardy. Scouted out the whole area. Looks like there's a trail we can follow.
A trail?
Aye. Left by fellow pirates, no doubt. To lead us to a safe harbor. There she is, Mr. Hardy. The fastest vessel ever built. Ready to set sail for the land of the flame.
I don't see any sails.
Shh. We must make our way aboard. Quietly. Avast, Mr. Hardy. Too many of them scurvy dogs to take head on.
Lily, I want to go home.
Quartermaster, steel yourself. Be your heart soaked in doubt, or be there a fire burning within. In the land we've seen behind shut eyes, the one of bright shores caressed by tide, where there's no pain, no fear, no fury, no lies. There we shall stand tall, our hearts full of pride. If your dreams are bold and by no man bound, if your soul is strong, unlike any other, able to build walls or tear to the ground, then yours is this world, my little brother.
This fellow is wise enough to play the fool.
Begins with an act of destruction.
Look what I found, Mr. Hardy. This chart will lead us away from peril and into safe harbor.
You shouldn't play with strangers. She wouldn't like that. She doesn't like it when you play with anyone but her. Lily, I think there's something in the dark.
Shh! Someone's coming.
Hello? Anyone there?
Bloody hell! Sod it. The chief wants it checked so bad he can bloody well do it himself.
This bottle do. Hurry, we have to secure it. They'll be here any moment.
Lily, I'm scared.
You should be scared. You know what happens if they find us. They'll send us back.
Thank you.
The door behind you!
We are now entering the eastern part of the borough. This particular area holds a special place in my heart, as I grew up not far from here myself. A few things have changed, it seems, for better or worse. I see children playing in the streets, not a care in their little minds. If it wasn't for their shabby clothes, one could almost forget about the crushing poverty that plagues so many of the local families. But what do we have here? A boy, sitting on a park bench, alone. Perhaps he won't mind if we pick his brain a bit. Good morning, young man. What's your name? Good morning, young man. What's your...
Morning.
Good man. Your morning. What's your name?
James?